You were my sister, my strength, and my bride. Take me to the King. Can I get a witness in here tonight? So can I tell you something? When everything is against you, it seems like the odds are against you, and it have counted you down for your way out of here, I want you to tell them this. If you got Jesus, tell them this. Say,
don't worry about me.
Y'all want to know why?
Cause I've got the victory.
Tell them no. Say the same thing again, brothers.
Don't worry about me. God knows I'm gonna be alright. Can I get a witness? How many of y'all believe that you got the victory right now? If you believe it, let me hear you say thank you.
Tell y'all a little secret. There's victory in God's power. There's victory in His love. There's victory in His joy. There's victory in His peace. And can I share a little secret with you? He gave all those things to me. And as long as I got Jesus, I got the victory. And I ain't weeping, pain, and your part. Wait a minute, no, it's gonna come in the morning.
How many ever been down by your friends? And you know what I found out? Sometimes family hurts you the most. Somebody in this place, don't joke with me, somebody raise your hand that's going through something right now. Tell me the truth, won't they lie on you, stick your knife in your back at the same time and smile at you, call you everything but a child of God, blow those in your face. But I got a question for you right now. If you know that God has made a way for you in the past, look way down the line and think about what you've been through and look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, in spite of what I'm going through, when I look back over my life and see how far God brought me, say, I may have to cry sometimes. I may have to shed a few tears, but I'm gonna be all right, because as long as I got Jesus, I don't want nobody to worry about me. Hey. Oh, 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 oh. Can I get a witness in there? A hobby. I want you to hold my hand now because I feel the Holy Ghost coming over here. Oh. 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 Spiritual, just tell them how I feel. You should feel the same way.
I'll be all right. I'll be all right.
Against your home, the enemy came up against your children, the enemy came up against your name, the enemy came up against your character. You will against your health. The enemy came up against your finances. The enemy came up against your vision. The enemy came up against your business.
Let us stand, please, and receive our family. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. For I know my Redeemer lives, and after my skin is destroyed, this I know, that in my flesh I shall see God. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, I walk through the valley of the shadows of death. I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. For God is my refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faint nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. But those that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles, and they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yea, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the river, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble. And he knows those who trust in him. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And lo, he said, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believeth in me, though he may die, he shall live. So let not your heart be troubled, nor believe. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that Where I am, there ye may be also. And where I go, you know. And the way, you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. These things I've spoken to you, that in me ye may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angel, nor principalities, nor powers, nor thing present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, created thing, shall be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. He said, behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, as the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. But I live on in the flesh. This would mean fruits from my labor. Yet what have I chosen? I cannot tell, for I am hard pressed between two, having the desire to part and be with Christ, which is far better, for our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly body, that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to the work by which he is able even to subdue all things to him. Amen. But we do not want you to be informed, brethren, that those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. Even so, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive remain unto the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who shall fall asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the voice of the archangel, and the dead in the Christ shall rise. Amen.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing it will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing it will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. It's a highway to heaven. Oh, none can walk up there but the pure heart. It's a highway to heaven. She is walking up the King's highway. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure heart. It's a highway to heaven. She is walking up the King's highway. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. When the Spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes, 'cause I am free. Praise the Lord, I am free. I'm no longer bound. No more chains holding me down. My soul is resting. He's just a blessing. But praise the Lord, hallelujah, I am free. She is free. Praise the Lord, she is free. She's no longer bound. No more chains holding her down. Her soul is resting, and it's just a blessing. But praise the Lord. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. She is free.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here to celebrate the homegoing sister Annette Crockett. Order of service, Old Testament, New Testament, Pastor Thurman Caldwell, is he present, is he here? Prayer, Bishop Adkins, got a poem, music selection, Sister Stephanie Meade, acknowledgement and condolence, Ashley Black, word of reflection, Pastor T.C. Caldwell, praise dance, Jay Deja, Davis, video presentation, slide, remarks too many, special remarks, Leon Chism, music selection, make a day, fruitish, and then words of comfort. We're going to move in that order.
Can everybody say praise the Lord? Can we just clap our hands and make the devil mad? Come on, let him know he don't have any victory here. God gets all the glory, God gets all the honor, and God gets all the praise. Listen, if her life and her legacy meant anything to you, can we just make some noise and take control of this house? My God, my God. Old Testament scripture, Psalm 24, just want to start in verse number 7, which simply says, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. And then I want to turn in our New Testament, To 2 Corinthians 5, beginning in verse 1, for we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, an house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we should not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon, that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Thus ends the reading of the word of God. May God add a blessing to the reader, hearers, and doers of his word. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your goodness and your mercy. We bless you for your loving kindness. We ask God that you would meet us here, that you would be with this family in the name of Jesus. God, I especially lift up a special prayer for my brother and my friend, Brother Ernest Crockett, but this entire family, God, touch them as only you can. You told us, God, and you reminded us that our weeping may endure for a night. But the good news was that joy was coming in the morning. So God, we thank you now. There is not a hurt that you cannot heal. There's not a problem that you cannot solve. So we entrust this family. We entrust all that we're dealing with today into the matchless hands of God. For we know that you are our solution. You are our remedy. So God, we thank you in advance. And as we go through this time together, we rest assured that you are still an on-time God. And for that, we give you glory. For that, we give you honor. And for that, we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God, everyone. Let's give him thanks for this opportunity to be here and praise the Lord for the life of Annette Crockett. I sit and wonder what the angels said that day when they came together just to guide you away. Did the angels hold and caress you with love? Did they sing you a song about heaven above? Were you really ready, or did you try to hold steady? No matter how you felt, I knew when I got the word, my heart had just melted. Now it's time to say goodbye, but all I can do is cry. I don't want to let go of the precious love I know. Lord, show me how to survive, for I know my Aunt Nett is still alive. This can't be true, not calling home, asking or speaking to you. Lord, please help guide my family through. Aunt Nett, we will forever miss you. Love, Tynesha.
Because the Lord is my shepherd,
yes, sir.
I have everything I need.
Yes, sir.
He lets me rest in the meadow's grass, then leads me beside the quiet stream. He restores my failing health, and he helps me to do what honors him the most. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe, 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 safe. I am safe in his arms. Because the Lord, he's my shepherd, I have everything I need. He lets me rest in the meadow's grass. Then he leads me beside the quiet stream. He restores my failing health, and he helps me to do what honors him the most. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe, 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 safe. I am safe in his arms. When the storm, when the storms of life are raging, and the billows, can't you see them? Oh, roll, and I'm so glad that he shall hide me. I'm safe in his arms. When the storms, when the storms of life are raging, and the billows, can't you see the billows roll, and I'm so glad he shall hide me. Say I'm so glad, glad he shall hide me. Say when the storm of life are raging, I can't find no place to run. He shall hide me, he shall hide me, he shall hide me. I'm covered, I'm covered in his love. Lord, I've been washed, washed in his blood. Yeah, he shall hide me, he shall hide me, he shall hide me, hide me, hide me, hide me, hide me, hide me. I'm safe in his, in his loving arms, in his arms, in his arms. I am safe in his arms. Oh, yes, I am.
Hallelujah. I will be reading the acknowledgments and condolences. Prince of Peace, Missionary Baptist Church of Jesus Christ, wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Psalms 27 and 14. To the family of the beloved Annette Crockett, the pastor, Reverend Richard J. Clark Ministries, officers, and members of the Prince of Peace Missionary Baptist Church of Jesus Christ, Kansas City, Missouri, extend our deepest and sincere sympathy to you for the loss of Annette Crockett. May you rely heavily upon your Heavenly Father for comfort to sustain you at this time. God's ways are past finding out, but there is always good in them for those who trust him. We know that today your hearts are heavy and filled with sorrow, but know that God is still with you and that he will strengthen you during this difficult time. God's word let us know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Psalms 35. Whereas it's pleased our Almighty God to receive Sister Crockett, no more will she have to hasten and escape from the storms and tempests of this earth. The heart will know no more pain, sorrow, or terrors of death. She is free at last. Sister Crockett has fought the good fight, finished the course, kept the faith, and now has received the promised reward of rest from her labor in the presence of our Lord. Lift up your heads and be strong. The Prince of Peace Church family will be praying for you, for time and prayer will help you at this time. May God your hope and look up to the hills from which cometh your help. May God bless you and give you strength and courage. Sympathetically yours, Reverend Richard J. Clark, Pastor, Prince of Peace Church family. Memorial Church International, Matthew 5 and 4. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Annette Chism-Crockett, we, the members of Memorial Church International, wish to express our heartfelt sympathy in the loss of your loved one, Miss Annette Chism-Crockett. Our hearts, prayers, and thoughts go out to Brother Ernest Crockett, along with the entire Crockett family. To the family, in times like these, encourage yourself in the Lord and rely upon the Word of God for daily strength, comfort, and peace. We have his assurance that the ultimate end is not death, but eternal life. It is our prayer that you will find renewed courage in the days to come. We encourage you to cherish each precious moment God allowed you to share with Annette. Reflect upon the many memories that flood your hearts and minds. You will miss her, but listen to God with a broken heart. He is not only the doctor who mends it, but he is the father who wipes away the tears. He will heal your heart with the passage of time. So continue to wait on the Lord and be of good courage. He shall surely strengthen thine heart. We, the Memorial Church International, say to you that we are calling your name out before God in constant prayer. We know and believe wholeheartedly that a family that prays together truly stays together. We exist to be a support network to the body of Christ. So today, we gather around you with loving support, care, and concern, knowing and believing that if you can stand the pull, our God will pull you through because of Christ. Apostle Larry B. and Pastor Olivia C.Q. Aiken and the entire Memorial Church International family. I'm also going to acknowledge additional condolences from Reverend T.C. Codwell, the pastor at the Spring Hill Missionary Baptist Church, Deborah Daniel with Memorial Church, Sister Brenda Whitley with Memorial Church. Donnell and Cynthia Green. Wilma True Love with Memorial. The staff of Memorial Shepherd, well, Memorial International Shepherd staff. Looks like Donna. And then additional staff from Memorial International Church. At this time, the family would like to thank everyone for sending a card, a text, food, whatever you have done during this time. The family sincerely thanks you.
Every heart say amen. Amen. If you love Jesus, say amen again.
Amen.
I met Annette through Brother Ernest Crockett. Myself and an engineer were hiring platers at the time. Ernest came in as a job applicant, and he was well qualified. After a few years, me and my wife went over to visit with Ernest and Annette. And since then, we've been friends ever since. And I just thank the Lord for Ernest's friendship. Fact about it, he had such good friendship with me. He was my best friend. Have you ever had a best friend besides Jesus? Amen. Ernest was that best friend. And yes, when Stephanie sung that song, "Because the Lord is my shepherd," that told a lot about Annette. Can I get a witness? Because she is safe in his arms right now. Can I get a witness? And I tell you that when she gets full of the Spirit, amen, and that gold teeth in her mouth get to shining. Can I get a witness? Amen. She can shout all over the place. Amen. Amen. I observed it one time when Ernest was trying to hold her down. Well, you couldn't hold her down because the Lord had her. Can I get a witness? And the Lord is not going to hurt his people. Can I get a witness? Amen. 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 And I know that we're on a time limit, but as I go to my seat, I just want to let you know that I love Ernest Crockett and Annette. They've been friends of me and my wife for a long, long time, and I will never, ever forget them. I am reminded of an old man that had a barbershop. He had a barbershop in his living room. He only had one chair because he was the only barber. And then he had a bell upside his door. That when the customers opened the door, they would ring the bell. But upstairs, he had a sick wife. And every time she needed some water, some medicine, she would ring a bell also. Then he would run up the stairs and see about his wife and see what she needed. While he was up tending to his wife, the bell downstairs would ring, signifying that he had a customer. So then he would run downstairs and cut some hair. Can I get a witness? While he was cutting hair, the bell upstairs would ring again. His wife needed to go to the restroom. He was tending to his wife, and then while he was up tending to his wife, the bell would ring downstairs. Can y'all get me? He'd run downstairs and tend to the haircut, make sure that everything was all right. Well, this went on for a few years, and the old man was getting tired. So he decided to do something. So what he did, he moved his chair upstairs so that he could watch his wife and cut the hair at the same time. Can I get a witness?
But then he remembered that since he moved his chair upstairs, the living room was empty. And the folks that come in would thought he was out of business. But he made a sign. He ran downstairs and posted that sign in the window. That sign said, "Still in business, but I've moved upstairs. I want to let you know that Annette Crockett is still in business, family. But she just moved upstairs." Can I get a witness? Let me tell you what, down here we have medicines. But when she moved upstairs, can I get a witness? No more medicines. Down here we have potholes, is that right? But I heard Revelation 21 and 21 said that the streets in heaven are made of pure gold, transparent as glass. Amen, amen. We have heartaches and heart attacks down here. But when she moved upstairs, no more illness, no more hospitals. Oh, let me quit now. All right.
I'm gonna go. Hey, hey. I'm gonna say I'm only moved when you tell me to move, Jesus. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. And I thank you for delivering me, for setting me free, for washing me clean.
Have one more witness. Come here, Rubenstein.
Come on, somebody praise him right now. He deserves a praise. everybody, look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
I need you.
You need me.
You need me.
We're all a part.
We're all a part of God's body.
Stand with
me. Stand with
me. Look at somebody, tell them, agree with me. When your mama say, I need you.
I need you.
Let me hear you. You need me.
You need me.
For we're all.
We're all a part of God's body.
Stand with me.
Stand with me.
Agree with me.
Agree with me. We're all a part of God's body.
It is His will.
It is.
You
are
But if you think that's something, God's chemical laboratory of redemption took my black soul and dipped it in red blood. And I came out white as snow. Oh!
On the program now is the remarks, 2 minutes. We want to forego that to give me, say we ran out of time, but we're going to take a little time to preach God's word. Amen. Amen. Just for I want to say to the family, we are praying for you. Amen. We are here to give closure. Many times we realize that this is important, amen, for the family. Amen. They only get one closure for every loved one, but it's not the end. Can I get a witness? For this is a homegoing celebration. Amen. And I want to share briefly from very familiar passage of scripture, John 14, chapter, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. And I want to share with you that one of the reasons why we can rejoice and a sitting like this, because number one, she knew Jesus as a personal Savior. Many times we fail to remember that the Word of God is a revelation that the world don't have access to. It is in this passage of scripture that Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. I want to let you know that she was a preacher. I wish I had somebody in here. She was a preacher of the gospel. Many times we fail to understand that every one of us is called to preach. Come on, preacher. We may not have the ordination to stand behind the sacred desk, but we're still preachers. Number one, she had a prepared place. And she lived a life. As I said it and I listened, I watched the praise dancer, and I watched all of those things that were saying. I can see her now. When the praise dancer got up, she was the one on the floor looking in. And you know, sometimes as a man of God, you need some fire in the fireplace before you get up. She was an instrument in worshiping God. She always had a desire to praise God in the sanctuary. From the very first time that the prayer offered, I know some of them at Prince of Peace would wonder why every time the prayer is offered, she's the first one at the altar.
Well,
but let me tell you, I don't know about you, but if you are living for God, you know that your help comes from Him. Life has a way of bringing burdens, and she know that she could cast her burdens on the Lord. Amen. She was one that was a let me tell you, sometimes she was a worship director because the way she praised God. Amen. And I sat there and I reminisced as I listened to all of the programs and listened to all of those things. She had a prepared place. But I just want to let you know, and we're getting that, and the gospel in the book of scripture that is written, we need to let others know that we have a Savior. The flow that would flow from our heart should be that which brings a revelation of our relationship with God. And I want to share briefly today that she had a prepared place. And she knew that where she was going was a better place than that. I heard James in the 5th chapter, James said, let him that preach realize that we are the preacher to call sinners from the error of their way. Now, I thought about the fact that she was a preacher because her lifestyle and her testimony was that which gave reverence to God. The sinners, the need to err of their way. And everybody, most time, we want to say that only the preacher, the pastor, have the preacher, but the Bible calls us in James 5:20 to all be preachers. What other way that God can save a soul? Because everyone is not gonna come into church on Sunday morning. But her life, I believe her life was a life, because what I seen was, it was evidence that she had a relationship with God. She was saved, her soul was saved, but when we need to let others know that we are converted by the life we live. She lived a life that many times we do not understand. Let us know that he which is converted need to convert sinners. And I can understand this, and I can say for sure, I knew this from evidence, that her life touched her family life. Amen. There are many times, amen, she come in with tears in her eyes, but she came rejoicing. She was there, Pastor Clark, pray for me. She was talking to my dad. I used to hear him saying, Pastor, pray for me. And I used to hear some saying, that why does she always run to the altar? She said, I know from which my help comes. She said, my help comes from God. God have called us to show sinners to err from their ways. How shall they be saved except God has a preacher? And I didn't come here to preach her funeral, but she already to eulogize because she lived the life that she spoke about. There's a sense in which we cannot convert others, but we can also live a life that show others that there is a God. In order that when others see us, they ask the question, what is the hope? And somebody need to know that there is a sense in which we can convert others by the way we live. Her life was, and I'm just only going to speak on this because if I go into my sermon, we're going to go over time. There's a sense in which men must turn. Amen. And I would dare ask a testimony from those that she lived with, that there was a profound effect on the life that she lived. Yet, we need to understand that Christ had called all of us to make a difference. There's yet a difference in the third sense in which only God can convert men. But let me tell you, he has called us to have an impact on those around us. We are not to confuse preaching with a man of God that stands behind the desk. Preaching is a lifestyle. And I believe that she lived the life that she spoke of. Let me make a startling statement. Every one of us today are a preacher in some respect. The life we live so others notice and ask the work, the life, the service that we give. The preacher role, she lived a preacher role in that she presented the truth. Her role that she gave was to respond to the love of God. Every time that she came into the service, amen, this is Sister Annette funeral, homegoing celebration. We reflect on the goodness that she was, and I know this family gonna miss her. We're gonna miss the Prince of Peace, but the Lord loved her more. And God providential love and gracious overrode the atmosphere of death. Because God, Jesus said, in my Father's house there are many mansions. And because he had prepared a place for her, amen, we can rejoice. But in our rejoicing, we have to remember there is a message for all of us, that God have called us to be his witnesses. Amen. Every one of us, in so many ways, is a preacher. Amen. You may not have the reverend in front of your name, but we ought to live the life so others can see the goodness of God. And I can say today that the Lord is using everyone that was preached for him. And I heard somebody say, Lord, let me seek to do your will so that others can see your handiwork. We're living in times where there are so much uncertainty. Somebody need to know that there is a reality and serving a true and living God.
I'm trying to cut across so I won't get too hung up here, because I just want to let you know that she had fought a good fight. The evidence that her life was for the glory of God is evidence because of who is sitting here in this service. But I know one thing, that serving the Lord will pay off. And I think I need to piggyback on Brother Cardwell, that she had gone to a better place. The truth of the matter is that she fought a good fight. She kept the faith, and now she's resting in the presence of the God. For he said, I'm going to prepare a place, and it's only for prepared peoples. Can I get a witness? And I want to ask you a question today. Are you ready to meet your Lord? But one of these days, it won't be very long, that we don't know when, we don't know where. But I know I will be somewhere listening for my name. Can I get a witness? There will be no more on the other side. She, we can praise God. I heard somebody said we'll be praising him from noon to evening, from morning to noon. And somebody said I'll be praising him all day long. I don't know about you, but I believe that the sister has already joined the praise crowd, because every time the church opened there, she was one of the praise instrument. And I know that serving the Lord will pay off after a while. And I heard James said that we are to let others know who Jesus is. And it's not because of what we say, it is because of the life that we live. I want to let you know that don't worry about sister. She's gone on to a better place. And I would encourage you, just stay with God. For serving the Lord will pay off after a while. She's already had made her transgression. She's gone to a better place. But I can see her looking over the portals of glory. And I want to let you know, she is now making intercessions for you and I. But I want to let you know that serving the Lord will pay off after a while. Yes, she fought a good fight, and she finished her course. I'm reminded today that there was an athlete that had a position on the football team. And when he was riding the school bus, when he got off of the school bus after a long day of practice on the football field, he would get off on a rock road that went by the graveyard. And when he went by the graveyard, he was walking with his friends. But one day, when the time for the football get ready, his coach ran him off a hard. And when he got off the bus, school bus, the driver noticed that he went through the graveyard. And and one day the driver asked him a question, why is it that every day You get off the school bus now, you go through the graveyard. And he said, well, when I got off of running the scrimmage, I have to run 2 miles with my pads on. But when I get off the bus, don't you know, my father, you see that house sitting on the other side of the graveyard? She said, the closest way for me to get home is go through the graveyard. I'm tired. And he said, the school bus driver said, yes, I noticed. That's a beautiful house. He said, my father built that house. And I used to walk the long way around. Every now and then, we need to understand, sickness will come. That's the long way around. But he said, when I get off, I go right through the graveyard. That's the closest way I can make it home. I don't know about you. I'm getting ready to go through the graveyard. Every now and then, my burdens get heavy. Every now and then, you might have to stop by. Providence is closed up. Research, Truman Medical, good God Almighty. But one of these days, we go home, gotta go home. And I heard, good God Almighty, the closest way is through the graveyard. I heard Jesus say, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Where I am, you can be also. A few days ago, he called a name, and I heard, good God Almighty, she got her bags ready, and the quickest way was through the graveyard. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad I got my business fixed. I don't know when, and I don't know where, but I'll be ready to go my way. Sleep on, Sister Annette, for after a while, by and by, we all, you better get ready, you better get ready. Yes, if you don't know him, tell the Lord, Father, I need you. I'm not everything that I ought to be, but I found out that your son died on Calvary. And when he died, he said, whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Goodbye. Goodbye, Annette. I'll see you on the other side. I don't know what day is going to be, but I'm on my way through the graveyard, because on the other side, there will be joy. Good God Almighty, I don't know about you, family, rejoice. Yeah, you can rejoice because she was ready. And I will, if you're gonna ask her, if anybody wanna know where I am, I heard the writer say there'll she be somewhere around the throne telling God, thank you. Every now and then, tell God thank you, because it's always the one thing you're going to do on the other side. And I can remember, come on, y'all, I can remember every Sunday morning, Annette will be praising God, even when everybody was sitting down, she'll get up sometimes and make a run around the sanctuary. Somebody would ask them, why is it you're running? It's because she was letting us know she had another destination. Serving the Lord will pay off after a while. Keep on serving the Lord. There is a sense that we must know that one of these days we all gonna go this way. She preached her funeral. She lived a life. Now she's gone home to reward family. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. There may be a sense that you have lost a loved one, but you get ready. If you don't know Jesus Christ is part of your sin, and you want to see your loved one, tell the Lord, pray this prayer. Say, Lord, forgive me. I'm a sinner. I messed up. I believe that Jesus was the Son of God. I believe that he died and was resurrected. I believe that he is the Savior of the world. Lord, forgive me of my sin. Come into my heart and save me. If you prayed that prayer, but really believe it, make a confession. Tell Bishop Reverend Carwell, myself, and we will give you the next step. You don't have to live here with uncertainty whether or not you see your loved one again. For she'll be somewhere around the throne. Amen. Amen. God can convert sinners to saints. We come at this time, give ourselves over to the funeral director. We ask you to stand and remain standing till the family has exited.
live is Christ, and to die is gain. But if I live only in the flesh, this will mean fruit. For my labor, yet what I shall choose, I cannot tell, for I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the coming of our Savior.
Thank you.